Vicky McClure, ladies and gentlemen, everybody. How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm good.
Now, what can you tell us about the mysterious Mrs. Jones?
Well, I don't want to spoil too much. I think that scene explains well what our department is. The great thing about the series is you're in lots of different locations at different times, and when you're in the department, you know, it's great for Alex and to sort of discover what his new role is.
Yeah.
But as Mrs. Jones, she has an energy with him, and then like a relationship with Blunt and a relationship with Crawley, and yet she's quite a parenting with Alex as well. So I got to play lots of different
feelings in it, which was
nice, rather than just being sort of a direct spy, so to speak.
Is it fair to say her moral compass is constantly wavering?
Yes, exactly, yeah. I should have said that.
Pardon?
I should have said that.
No, your answer was longer, which makes it better. What appealed to you about Mrs. Jones and the show, you know, in terms of the tone and the style and stuff?
Well, I was honest from the start. I'd not heard or read the books because I'm a bit older than Otto.
You're not.
But I asked my nephew, who's 12 years old, and said, have you ever heard of a book called Alex Rider? And I got a response of, yeah, like I was stupid. So obviously I went and did my research, and it's great. It's an amazing job to be part of something that is pure adventure. You know, there's so much action in it. And, yeah, I didn't even really consider not doing it because it was a great part.
What have we got to look forward to? I guess, does Mrs. Jones go on a bit of a journey alongside Alex?
Yeah, I mean, we had loads of scenes together and we had a lot of fun. There's lots of stuff in the department as well, but I do have to wear a snowsuit at one point, which I really liked.
There aren't many people that I would kind of like, my legs would go to jelly, stood in front of, but Stephen Delaney is probably one of them. He terrifies me, just as a human
being. You
and
me both.
What's he like? What's he like to do stuff with?
I wish he was here.
Yeah.
He's got the driest sense of humour, hasn't he?
I didn't understand it at first. Yeah. I didn't get the sense of humour, but as we did shot more and more,
is he taking the mick out of me?
Yeah, yeah.
Not daft. It gets to the point where you all get, you know, it gets to about 4 o'clock, everyone's a bit tired, and then everyone gets like the silly hour, and he started to join in. So I saw a completely different side to him. He's great. I mean, he's fantastic in this, but he was really special to work with, yeah.
I mean, it's just his voice, isn't it? As well?
He's great as well, because he's constantly testing you in the scene, but also kind of as a person. He keeps you on your toes, because obviously he requires the best quality of work, you know? So it's great. You feel like you have to rise to his level, which is really, really fantastic. And Vicky as well.